we hear a lot about that debate of audience versus contextual targeting. And to be honest, at least where we are today, I think it's the wrong question. It's not either or. It's not audience or contextual. The question should be, how do I get the best out of both? So what we're seeing, and live sports is a really great example. With all live sports on pause right now, lots of advertisers had pretty significant budgets allocated this year for live sporting events, and they still have the desire to reach those audiences. So we're seeing a huge surge in demand for some of our sports fan audiences, which look at viewers of sporting events from past seasons, previous years, for things like golf and baseball, and giving advertisers the opportunity to reach those. So that takes care of it from an audience standpoint, but then you layer on that contextually relevant piece. So one example was this recently, a CPG company who had tagged a lot of money for part of their media plan for sporting events, still wanted to reach those audiences, but they wanted to do so in food and recipe-oriented content. And that's that contextual layer that you can put on top of that, or folks who've wanted to, say, avoid some of the really high-risk content related to COVID-19, some of the tragedy-related content, have the ability to layer on that, avoid that high-risk content while still reaching those sporting fan audiences who they had sought to reach and potentially in a pretty cost-effective manner with everything going on in the world, trying to make every penny count is definitely something that advertisers are seeking. The tools available now are taking a lot of the traditional audience and contextual targeting tools and using them together in potentially more innovative ways than folks had historically. They probably kept those pretty separate and starting to merge them. But I think where the industry is going is to have those which are separate solutions and offers and market today really start to merge. So we're already partnering with Xandr and other ad platforms to bring cookie-free, contextually based demographics to market, which has been widely popular, for example, in Europe, where there's GDPR impacted countries, to be able to take some of those tenets of age and gender targeting and make that available in a contextual standpoint. And then I think where the industry is going is to expand that to behavioral audiences and really merge those two. So the solutions are not just fully separate, that the solutions start to take on this predictive capacity to take the best of TV viewership, digital activity, and start to merge them into single offers that really just propel the industry forward from an innovation standpoint.